It was this beautiful cuttlefish at the New England Aquarium, this absolutely magical creature that was just looking at me, that was responding to me.
This tiny little squid came right in front of my mask and I had to cross my eyes to see what it was, and it squirted ink right at my face.
I glanced down for about that long and I looked up, gone. Just gone.
There seemed to be one that was studying me as much as I was studying it.
They're the closest thing to aliens you can get without actually having to get on a spaceship.
We're studying an alien that's kind of present in the room all the time, and I really like that. Octopuses and squids, just something about them is really captivating to the imagination.
It's a really incredibly diverse and incredibly broad group of animals that's been around for a really long time.
They're intelligent, they have these amazing camouflage displays. If they were able to live longer than 2 years, they would take over the world.
They're also really interesting on a molecular level. They have a lot of novel genes.
And then you start looking at them neurologically or evolutionarily or physiologically, and they also break all of those rules consistently over and over and over again.
They're incredible animals that have developed brains and eyes completely separate from vertebrates. And
it takes some dedication to decide to spend your life studying this very super interesting but sort of esoteric thing.
Cephalopod scientists, they are some of the most enthusiastic group of scientists that I've ever seen, I think.
I think that they're ocean nerds, and it's awesome.
I don't know another group where you can sit and talk about skin for hours, complex problem solving for hours.
And it's really great, I think, because it's such a wonderful community to share information and our passion with one another.
There's so much more to learn than even the stuff we're already excited about.
I think because there's so much that we don't know, I just want to know more.
I would like to understand how the arms are communicating with each other.
How do you build a brain that drives such complex behaviors in a way that's completely different than our own?
Why can an animal be so complex but live 3 or 4 years max?
And if they're doing well in a changing environment, we should probably try and understand why, because they're going to be super important in the future as things change.
And so I think cephalopods become an emblem for all of that, for caring about the world's oceans and also for understanding who we are, how we got here, and why we are the way we are.